So, who will tell you the first time I met? Now I know whose fault this is. I was going on a lot of family, you know this, a women's conference, and I don't know how I did not notice her before we got the van, and we had to pull over on the side of the road, and she was in the van before. And this big girl walks out of her van, comes out to our van, and I'm thinking, who is she? Because she, I knew in my mind, this girl thinks she cute. And so I'm watching her, and she comes up, and she has bad sunglasses on. It was sharp. But she's walking into the van, and she gives her little dictation to us. And then the whole time I'm thinking, she thinks she cute. And I don't know if I'm going to like her or not. Being honest. And but look at that, we're almost 20 years in the making of a beautiful friendship. And what makes us, I think, so wonderful together is we're totally different. Lemmon is the calm, rational one. I'm a little eccentric, maybe. And the difference with Lemmon, another story, A-Lock, as you know, we were at another conference. This was a singles conference, and Lemmon was our chaperone. And there was a car, we were in the passenger front seat. And there was a car coming in our lane. And the car was about to hit us. Well, everybody started screaming. Me being the spiritual one, started speaking in tongues. Because that's, you know, that's what you're supposed to do. But I'm looking at Lemmon, and she's like this. Everybody's screaming, ah! So afterwards, I'm like, Lemmon, didn't you notice that car was about to kill us? And she said, I saw it, but what can I do? If we die, we die. There's nothing I can do about it. And that's how Lemmon always is. She's the calm, rational person that I need in my life. And so I'm so thankful that God has put us together to calm me and for me to give her some excitement in her life.
Whatever.
But I love you. Thank you for being my BFF.
Can't wait for our next trip.
All right.
Thanks, Karen. That was beautiful. It's hard trying to find a BFF. It's kind of hard dealing, you know, with women. I know she's your BFF and all, but she's my sister. And she is the calm person, but she can be a little rowdy too at times. So, Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
Hello.
Lemmon actually asked me to do a poem for her several weeks ago, but she knows how I operate. I actually just wrote it today, Lemmon. I'm sorry. I actually woke Nancy up this morning before 8 o'clock.
That's good.
I needed some details so that I could write it. And she wasn't too happy with me waking her up. But at any rate, I want to thank you, Nancy, because had it not been for you, I would not be able to pen this one. And I call it One of a Kind. Mic is leaving. Some 50 years ago, down in Somerville, Tennessee, Augustine and Tommy were blessed by God with a musical prodigy. Lemonstein, she would be called, a name that's quite unique. For they knew right then she was one of a kind to no uncertain degree. As she blossomed and grew, as years passed by, so did her gift in song. And along with it, a personality of which to her is only belong. She exudes originality, mere words can scarce describe. And she's such a one-of-a-kind kind of girl She has her own words to match her vibe. She's remarkable in every sense of the word. Extraordinary, you see. She's remarkable, without a doubt. Delivering style in high quality. She's lemonderful and brings excellence as she heeds our master's choice, touches others through her love and care and concern and her blessed melodious voice. She brings lemonosity as she enters a room filled with a glowing lemon-hued light. And with an earnest and true humility, she's the same both day and night. So I share in pride with the other 8 kids, cause she's my sister from another mother. I salute you and love you, dear Lemmon Steen. You're one of a kind, like no other.
All right, then.
Okay, words from Tim Holt. Tim Holt. All right,
Tim. All right, Tim.
I was really honored when Lemmon asked me if I'd be willing to share some words with y'all this evening. I consider that I've always been blessed to be surrounded by good people.
The mic up.
Pick up the mic.
Okay.
Yeah, go ahead.
I was really honored when Lemmon asked me to say a few words this evening. And I've always said that I've been blessed to be surrounded by good people. So my NES family has become my family here. My family, I have no family here aside from them and the friends that I've made here. Lemmon's always been good to me, and she's been there for me in times when they were rough. And I just wanted to say I thank you and I love you very much.
Continue to allow God to use you and inspire many. God bless you.
Amen.